All right. Well, we. Is he in here?
Miles.
JD. JD, we're over here. What are you standing in front of?
A motorhome. Didn't you get a trailer?
When have I ever reviewed a trailer? Come on, get over here. We gotta do the show.
I'll tell you what. Reviewing a trailer would be 100 times cooler than reviewing this thing.
What's wrong with this?
It's just too sporty. You can't live in it.
That's a great point. Oh, the Millennium Falcon thing again. It's always about that. This is the Stelvio Quadrifoglio, by the way.
Yes.
505 horsepower. You can't live in it, but boy howdy, could you drive it?
Yeah, Quadrifoglio, right? So
four-leaf clover in Italian.
Yeah, nice. And they have a four-leaf clover right there. Over there.
They do. You don't like it.
Eh, you know, you stamp a car, whatever.
I'm Miles Branman.
I'm Julien Melnick.
I'm the enthusiast.
And I'm not.
This is Wheel Report.
Car news we choose.
Yeah, it is.
Let's get into it.
Oh, sorry. Oh, shoot, that's mine. Let's get into it.
Okay, I already said it.
Let's get into it.
Okay.
Let's get into
yep.
it. What are your thoughts on side view mirrors?
Well, you know, honestly, when I used to ride bicycles, I'd hit them a lot. And
that's evil. On purpose?
Yeah, yeah.
Was it like a game, like 10 points per mirror?
Bam. It was great. Yeah, I got a little...
Didn't that hurt your hand?
I used to wear a gauntlet. They said that it was like some sort of continuous. I think there was they said the word infinity. I had this like gauntlet that was infinity.
Is that where the word gauntlet comes from?
I had
you throw down the gauntlet, you're actually throwing down a... the Infinity War. That's a gauntlet.
So
what Thanos is wearing in the movie, I understand now.
Literally called the Infinity Gauntlet.
Yeah. Well, it doesn't really matter. You won't be able to hit side mirrors anymore because they're going to replace them.
What? I know. You sent me the picture. I thought it was kind of cool. Actually, I think it's kind of cool.
Yeah.
But what I would think is a little bit cooler is if they were able to completely replace the side profile.
Yes.
Which they're not able to do.
Not yet.
In this design, at least, they have a kind of this little angular thing that comes out that looks like a sideways snorkel.
So they're going to use a camera instead of a side view mirror to project an image onto some screen inside the cabin of what a side view mirror would normally be seeing.
Mm-hmm.
So Audi has introduced this on their e-tron all-electric.
So Audi's making an innie? I'll be here all week.
That's awful. That's an awful joke.
Yeah.
And I loved it.
You can use it, aren't
Thank
you?
Thank
you. Yeah, you're welcome.
We're leaving that in, also because you edit this.
Lore is so hot.
Oh, goodness. It's 96. It's going to be 103 tomorrow.
I'm taking my shoes off and standing off.
Yes, I'm wearing pants. Oh, my goodness. You need to get some thicker soles, my friend. That is awful.
Van, you're not cutting it.
That camera is going to pick this up.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It'll see it.
Good. Audi has introduced a system where there's a camera mounted right there on the side mirror.
It's like you take the mirror part and you take it off and you just keep it.
And they just put a camera on.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that, I agree with you. I think that's kind of weird that if you're going to replace it, like actually clean up the whole side of the car,
you totally
right?
could do it too, because we have those 360 cams that exist in the cars nowadays. You just kind of create a little, I don't know, you could probably create some sort of gill type air filtration system, whatever, and then just have it on the lip of it.
Yeah, like there's got to be a way to mount it in a more agile or aerodynamic way.
Yeah.
I think also that opens up some opportunities for designers and engineers to kind of get crazy with the style of cars, because if you didn't have a door mirror, I don't know. Some cars might look better with it or without it, or I don't know. But
might get some more DeLorean style doors.
Yes.
Ooh, gosh, I love
those,
DeLorean
that would be
style
great.
Doors.
The other thing about Audi's system is that it's projecting the image onto an OLED 7-inch screen, and it's positioned, the monitors are positioned kind of just below where the door mirrors would be in a car. So it's kind of intuitive. You'd look in that direction anyway. And you can kind of zoom in and zoom out on the image, which is cool. So it's a little bit better than a standard door mirror.
I guess kind of because the habit's there, they got to keep those there. But I just, you know, why don't we just bring it into
the center display?
The center display.
Yeah. Well, as the center display gets bigger, maybe if they can split the screen, right and left.
Yeah.
That would be cool. I like that.
As you're about, because sometimes, actually, no, those exist. You go to make a turn, and with vehicles that have side-mounted mirrors, it'll actually show on the screen.
Honda Sensei. Yeah, they're lane watch, they call it.
Is that okay? That makes sense, because I've seen it in my mother-in-law's car, and she has a Honda.
Yeah.
I think she has a CR-V.
Now, some people love that, and some people hate it. Some people are like, oh, you just replaced what I was looking at with what's in my side view mirror.
Yeah.
So I guess it would, like, they're trying to find, I get what Audi's doing, they're trying to find a way to make it as smooth a transition as possible, mm-hmm. but I figure if you're gonna go with forward-facing tech, like, just go for it. And this is also a fan on your face.
Oh, thank God, it's 96 degrees.
Oh, geez, it's warm. The only other problem with the Audi system is that it's not gonna be offered in the US, at least not right now. Because
they hate the US.
No, it's actually not their fault. It's US regulators have said that this technology isn't ready for our roads, our production vehicles, which is a bummer because if it works, it's just like a door mirror. So what's the issue?
What roads do they need?
I don't know.
What kind of roads do they have in other countries? To tell you,
narrower roads, to be like worse
exactly.
roads.
I was about to say, I've driven in Europe, and yeah. the roads we have are so much wider.
They're just, I don't know, outside the US, countries are just much more flexible with tech and with, like, safety regulations. This one's a little shocking, and then somehow it's not. Hyundai, the Korean automaker, might buy
killer barbecue.
What did you say? Barbecue?
You're talking
about? It is delicious.
Yeah, Korean barbecue.
It is delicious. Okay. But they might buy Fiat Chrysler automobiles, the parent company yeah. of Dodge, Alfa Romeo, Ferrari, Maserati, Ram, Jeep,
God, it took
Chrysler.
That long to get to Jeep?
Oh,
they're the best.
Jeep's the best.
Out of all of those.
It's the best.
It's the best. Apologies for any sort of sound. We got yes. cars going all over
so
the place.
So many cars.
It's okay.
All the cars. We're shooting at a different time.
Yeah.
We're trying something new.
And we traded in gardeners for cars.
Yes, and you tried to shoot in front of a trailer that's not mine. So what are your thoughts? What if a Korean automaker
Ooh.
Owned a, well, it's actually, it's not even an American automaker. It's half Italian at this
oh,
point.
Oh, you
half
know
those
what?
Brands are Italian.
I have all these feelings.
Uh-huh.
Let me just say them right now.
It's been a while since you've had the feelings
I know.
That came from here.
Right, are you ready?
Yeah,
are you ready to hear
ready.
My feelings
just
about
release.
A Korean company owning all these?
Yes.
I don't care. Why not?
You really had me. You had me built
yeah.
up. I was ready for some strong impression.
Nope, no
and
impression.
And you know what? I completely agree. It doesn't
yeah,
matter.
It doesn't matter.
Because
you know, if they have capital,
yes.
manpower to do this and to go forward, and they have the technology and they have the innovators to do it, give
yep.
it to the right guy. Yeah, absolutely.
And build Inspector Gadget while you're at it.
Ooh.
Yeah. No. Well, so there are other foreign-owned automakers. You know, American. Brands owned foreign automakers. American brands owned Japanese automakers. Geely that owns Volvo is a Chinese company that owns Volvo, which is a Swedish brand.
Yeah.
Tata Motors, Indian company,
the
owns
company.
Jaguar Land Rover. They own the British. Yeah. What did you say?
You said Tata Motors.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Today's the day of poor jokes. Anyway, so this whole like other countries owning different countries' brands, it happens all the time.
Yeah.
Like you said, as long as the right people are in charge, Fiat Chrysler's CEO, Sergio Marchionne, he's done some good things, he's done
yeah.
some bad things. What I would say is that the Fiat Chrysler brand has not like had tremendous success under his authority, so you know, maybe it's time for some Korean blood on
yeah.
this one.
And who knows what they're gonna do. If they have passion to push this on these automakers
yeah.
to make good products for us, the consumers, and for you, the consumers,
mm-hmm.
I think it's a win.
I think it's a win too. 2019 Honda HR-V, they updated it, okay?
They put a C in front of it.
No, that's a different model. Why are you making fun? You like Hondas, you're
gonna
buy one.
I love Hondas.
The HR-V has been updated, it's got some new styling that came from the Civic and from the CR-V, its older brother of an SUV.
Yeah.
And it now is a volume knob.
Ooh.
It used to be fully touchscreen and it was really frustrating. Now it has a volume knob. That's exciting.
You know what? Actually, that does excite me. And you want to know why?
Why?
Because that means that Honda listened to the consumer.
Yes.
And that, when
yes,
a company-
Honda's very good about that,
when
actually.
A company goes, here you go, consumer, and the consumer goes, thank you, this sucks, don't like it. When an automaker listens,
yeah.
it just, it makes me want to, like, I trust them. I trust them.
Yep.
I trust they're gonna give me a vehicle because they're not creating to make themselves the money, although that is part of it.
Yep.
They're creating to really deliver a product.
Yes, deliver a product that people need and is usable on a daily basis.
And there are few automakers that do that.
Yeah, I agree. Like
Some do
really
very
well.
Well.
Others are just sort of like, we're gonna build this product according to our plan. We don't care whether you like it or not.
Yep.
They're not necessarily the most
no.
successful ones. That's why Honda is just straight up killing it. Did you know that the Honda Accord, if it was its own brand, outsells automakers like Mercedes-Benz entire lineups?
Really?
Yes.
The Accord is a great vehicle.
Yeah, And apparently a lot of people think so. Because you're doing it great. And the new HRV, you're great too. Except that Honda got rid of the 6-speed manual transmission for 2019.
In the HRV?
Yeah, now it's just a CVT. Do you know what a CVT is?
It's the continuous variable transmission.
Wow!
Yeah.
Holy butts! I didn't think you were gonna get that.
Oh,
that's
yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah, no, I know about the CVT because I don't really like it.
No one
that
really
much
does.
Because it feels.
It whines.
It does, and it's like a snowmobile transmission where you just go and then you just keep going. Like, there's no real feel of it.
Yeah, there's no feel of a change in gear, a defined
change
in gear. Yeah.
I can understand as far as ride quality.
Yeah, if you just want smooth.
Ride quality,
all the time.
Amazing. Yep. Driver experience, not so much.
Not
and
so
I do feel like there is. They can never be.
Perfect.
Yep. It's just kind of one or the other. I have a few things to say, and I have my list right here. I use technology because I'm a nerd.
We use technology. We're filming on technology. It's not the most advanced
driver
door mirror technology, but it is tech, and we're using it.
Do you kill trees with your paper? I don't. I pollute the air.
That hurt.
I'm going to name 5 actors.
Okay.
And I want you to tell me what they
male
all
or female?
Actors.
No, I was gonna tell you if they were male or female.
They're all male.
Oh, darn it.
Here are the 5 actors. You tell me what they have in common. You ready?
Yes.
Jason Statham, Tom Cruise,
yeah.
Arnold Schwarzenegger, Sylvester Stallone, and Jackie Chan.
Oh, this one's obvious.
What is it?
They all drive Mercedes AMG G-Wagons.
Oh.
For sure, right?
That's funny because that's a really good assumption. They're all like the big old burly badasses with a lot of money, so of course they would buy a big old burly vehicle that costs a lot of money.
Yeah.
No, that's not it. They all, at one point in time in their career, are stunt drivers. Did their own stunt driving for their own movies.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Wait. Jackie Chan did his own stunt driving?
Jackie Chan... It wasn't clear how much did most of, I'm not gonna say all, but out of all of these guys did the most stunt driving.
That's insane, because I knew Jason Statham, because that's like popularized. Like people know that Jason Statham, he does his own stunts
and
he's really good at them.
All those guys also do their own stunts. Jason Statham, interestingly enough, he was a driver on the national British team.
Holy cow, I didn't know that.
Yeah, he actually was a driver for them, which is kind of cool. He is known for movies like The Transporter.
Yes, of course.
He's in The Expendables and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But we've seen him behind Audis, Aston Martins, BMWs, just an assortment of vehicles.
Usually flying through the air with an explosion behind him.
That part,
as one does.
Might be more visual effects, but the likelihood of he actually being in the car is extremely high.
That's cool.
He does work with stunt drivers, and he's not always doing his own stunts, but he is known to do many of them when it comes to vehicles.
That's awesome. If I was an actor, I would want to do my own car stunts too.
It's very, very difficult. In looking into this, it's extremely hard, and these actors have to go through a lot of paperwork, sign a lot of contracts.
Shoot, I didn't even think about, all
that. It's
like,
very difficult.
Yeah.
Tom Cruise is known also. Let's finish off with Jackie Chan. Jackie Chan.
Oh boy, Chan man.
Not only does he do all of his own stunts, he does choreographed fight scenes. He does that for plenty of movies that he's not even in.
Dude, he's famous for that. Like his fight scenes are ridiculous, and like he's always using real life things. Like he'll use a table or he'll use a chair.
A pan.
Yeah.
Rush Hour. I just think of all
so
the stuff
fun.
In Rush Hour. He flips over a recliner and
he
always looks like he's no.
Yeah.
Like that's his thing.
Dude, but he's old now too.
He's very old. He's still doing it. He's still making movies.
Yeah.
Some of them not so good, but whatever, you know, he's Jackie Chan.
Yeah.
He choreographs fight scenes. He still does martial arts, and he is a stunt double for other martial artists. Jackie Chan.
How crazy would that be? Like you're the star of the movie, and you have to tag out for
Jackie Chan
to come in and do your stunts. That's like we're shooting the show. We're like, Jackie, would you come tag out? We got to do something where I throw the paper and he goes and catches it.
Yeah, no problem. Jackie Chan. Yeah, and just because we do talk about vehicles, let's finish out. He is known for driving a 120-ton dump truck and stunt driving that.
Dude, I can't even imagine 120 tons.
Yeah.
Dude, 240,000 pounds?
Yikes. Yep, he drove a 120-ton dump truck. Actually, I don't know if he's known for it, but now you do know. Yep, he stunt drives, not often, because a lot of his movies don't involve him driving, but 120-ton
dump
truck.
That's crazy. Yeah. Jackie, would you come take this end of the show for me? That'd be great.
Our budget doesn't allow for Jackie, but it's my friend Mark.
Ha!
Hey-ya! Oh, the floor's hot!
Ow!
The floor's hot!
Ow! Oh, yeah, you should get your shoes.